Hey, what's going on, you guys? Welcome to Draw It To. My name is Ramny, and this is another episode of Mini How To Draw. Before we begin, I just want to say a few things. As usual, what you guys need is a pencil, an eraser, any type of white paper, and black ink pen so you can ink afterwards. As you're watching this tutorial, remember that you can pause at any time so you can catch up on your drawings. We all draw at different speeds, so find a pace that works for you and stick to it. And also, if your drawings look a little different than mine, that is completely fine as well. So having said all of that, let's get to the tutorial. All right, you guys, so to get started with Black Flash, I've got my paper in landscape mode, and I'm going to be drawing his head kind of big, because what I want to do is I want to draw in the details in Black Flash's face, similar to what we did with the Freddy Krueger tutorial that I did last time. You just want to get in there and draw the little details that make up that shriveled, zombie-like skull, shrunken head face that he's got. So let's get started. And what I want to do is I want to draw a circle about this big on my page. And you guys will notice it's not quite a perfect circle. I've got a little bump here because he's going to be facing this way. So what I want to do is I want to create unevenness. So this side is going to be smooth. I'm going to draw a little chin right here. And then I'm going to draw the jaw over here. And I want it to kind of end up right there. Okay. So from here, I want to draw part of the neck. The neck goes down like that. And then the collar just goes in like this. I guess we can start working on the rest of the body. From here, the line going out like that. And right here, I'm going to extend it this way. And what I want to do is I want to draw about two lines. Actually, make it three lines from here to this point right here. Go down like that. And I want to draw it three times for the seams. And it's like the stitching and the seam combined. You just want to do that. Okay. Now from here, bring my shoulder out like this. And then kind of bring it down like this. And then from here again, this is the shoulder part, like that. All right, from here, I'm gonna draw a little seam or three lines going down. And then right here, actually, I'm gonna end it right here. I don't wanna go any further than that. I want to draw a half circle. But in order to give it a three-dimensional shape, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start over here. I'm gonna double up on this line. Once I get to here, what I want to do is I want to make this line thicker. So I want this width to be wider than over here. So here it's narrow, here it's wider. Okay, this is obviously going to be for that insignia for Black Flash or Zoom or whatever you want to call him. From here, let's just draw a line going this way. And then from this point, we just draw two lines going out like that. And then right here, I guess we could just do the little that point right there. I'm not going to draw any more than that. I think I'm just going to leave it right there. Okay. Over here, let's work on his shoulder on this side. It just goes down like this, and then down this way like this. And then, well, if you've got any space, you can make it go further, but I'm just going to leave mine like that. Before we draw the face, why don't we start drawing the hand? He's got his hand over here, and we're going to find a spot right here, and we're going to draw a line going up, and it slightly goes to the right. From here, I'm going to create this line, and it goes down like that. Another line over here, and it sort of goes like this. Now draw this lightly, because what it actually is it creates the spaces for the fingers. So I created one, two, three lines, four lines, and now you know exactly how the fingers are placed on the hand and how they stick out. All right, so let's start with this finger right here, the pointer finger or the index finger. And what you want to do, it's going to obviously going to occupy this space right here. You want it to go up this way. And then you want to divide it into rectangles. And then the point right here is going to be, it has like that sharp claw point like that. And you kind of want it, that's a good size for it right there. Now the next finger, I'm actually going to go from here. I'm going to do the same thing. One, two, three. So you guys notice that this one kind of goes up and it goes this way. And then this one goes this way even more. Now this finger is gonna go this way. Cut it off right there, like that. And then this one is gonna be tricky. You want it to go down. And then lastly, the pinky out like this. and then a little one, and this one goes down even more like this. So now you guys can see that he's got his hand in that curled pattern like this. We can erase the guidelines, and if you do that, it should look like a normal hand. Now we've got one finger missing, and that's the thumb. So now that we got these fingers down, let's find where the thumb goes. Oh yeah, forgot to mention, over here you kind of want to create the knuckles. So here's a knuckle right there, here's a knuckle. Right here, I sort of made it go all the way here, but you want to make a little bump right here as a knuckle, and right here's where that knuckle is. Now smooth it out. Don't make it look like rectangles anymore, so you want to round off the sharp corners of those rectangles so that it looks like fingers. Okay, there you go. So you've got the four fingers and then the thumb. Essentially just sticks out from here. You want it to go out like that right there, the sharp point. And then it just continues on from there. So it goes this way. Kind of hard to see, but that's how it's done. All right, let's zoom in a little bit on the face and let's get started with drawing the head. And I'm going to erase this right here. And I want to create, let's find the eye line. That's what we want to do. So the eye line sort of goes like this. Okay. And to help us even further, let's create like the, where the front of the face is going to be. It's going to look like that. And like this. So that's the center. Okay. So now let's figure out where the eyes are going to go. This is where the cross, where the two lines meet. You want to create a line just underneath it. And that's the brow. And then you want to create this, it almost looks like a heart shape from there. Okay. And that's obviously for the eye socket. So you want to make that heart shape, but you also want to round it off so it looks like that. Okay. Now from here, we draw the top part, but we don't finish it off because this is the part of the mask that comes, that's come off. So that's where you see his face. All right, now here let's kind of draw an oval where his ear is supposed to be. Draw it lightly for now. I'm actually going to bring it a little bit lower. Just like that. And then on this earpiece, We're gonna bring this towards where that circle is. And then it sort of goes down like this towards the bottom of the jaw. Okay, now over here, it's gonna go this way. And it's sort of gonna go out like this. We'll leave the rest for now. Now let's go over here. Let's find where the eye is going to be. With a curve like that, and like this, like that. And then you want to draw the eyeball sort of sitting really weirdly on top or inside the socket there. So here's the eyeball, it's not quite at the top. And then here's the pupil of the eye, and he's going to be looking, trying to make it so that he's looking at his hand. Okay. Going to darken this part of the eye right there, and I'm going to draw lines coming out from the eye, and that's all going to be dark later on. All right, now over here I'm going to make this weird shape for the nose, so it sort of goes out like this and then like that. It goes out like this. Now over here a little curve like this, and then here I'm going to draw kind of, think of a PlayStation controller. It's kind of the shape that you want. A little line over here, and then a circle over here for the other nostril. Okay, now let's draw some lines over here. And then right here, I want to draw this line like that. Now over here, he's got some black scarring right here. So from here, draw this shape right there, and then another one from there to there. So it's like a sideways, upside down L shape. And I want to create these circles as well. And under the eye, lots of wrinkles. Also above the eye, lots of wrinkles. So you want to make his face as mutilated as possible. And the way to do that is to not have smooth lines. So what you want to do is you want to create really rough lines as you are drawing the face. Okay, here's the lip now. Upper lip from here, bring it up like this, but that far. Down like this, and then up like this. Now, as we draw the lip, you kind of want to make it really rough, right? So to do that, you just add textures by adding random lines going out and in, and making sure that the lines that you're making are rough. Just like that, okay? Now let's draw the teeth. So I'm gonna draw a line like this, one over here, and one this way, faintly. Okay. I'm gonna extend it a little bit past this center line right here. All right, but the center line we're going to use just like that. Another one here. One big one right there. It's got very, very scary looking teeth. Another one right here. And then down at the bottom, smaller. There you go. I'm gonna fix the eye because what I want to do is I want to keep making it really rough looking. I made it a little too smooth. Okay, now from here, I want to add some shadow underneath here and also on the side and also right here. And this shadow right here sort of fades as you go down. Now from here, you want to make this big black scar. And it looks like that, and I'm going to shade that in. I'm going to extend this a little bit. I'm going to add a little bit more chin. If you guys don't have to do this if you don't need to. Now over here, I'm going to connect these two like that. And then I sort of bring this up slightly as I go down. And this is going to be his mask, all ripped apart and everything. As I go, I'm going to create the shadow right here. From here, I want to make some chin lines. Let me erase some of these lines right here. Try to erase the center line a little bit. Just some wrinkles for the chin, like that. Now you can go liberal with wrinkles, and you can draw as many wrinkles as you want. And the wrinkles just make it look like his skin is rotting, falling off his face. And on occasion, you want to draw some black spots like that. Okay. Now, as you're drawing the skin, you want to add a little bit of texture by drawing some cross-hatched lines. So if your lines go this way, you want it going this way. You want to make some of those lines darker than others. Added a little dot there for the pupil. I think it gives him a scary effect. So you want to just keep going and add as much detail as you feel. you want to make this part of the face as gory as you can. And darken those gums too. Oh yeah, and finish drawing the teeth on this side. Kind of forgot to do that. So you want to make sure that those teeth are drawn in. And those gums are blackened. There you go. Let's erase this part right here. Now I want to draw the eye on this side, and he's going to be squinting. He's got his eyes sort of shut. So from the right side, I just want to draw a line going across, and then a line like that. And I want to actually want to make this line narrow over here, and it gets wider as you get to this side. Okay, and then just a little wrinkle right there. All right, so let's draw the cheek. I'll draw a little line right here, and as I go down, I draw a cheekbone like that. Then I go down again. And then right around here, I bring it in like this. Okay, in his mask, we've got some wrinkles going like this. And wrinkles coming out of the side of the eye here. And some going up like this. Right, so like we did with zoom, up and down lines for the mouth, that pattern that he has in the mouth. Not too much though, because it starts to get kind of rotted on this side. So I'm going to start drawing wrinkles and lines, zigzag lines going out like that. So you wanna go back or go over here now and find where the mask, the jawline of the mask is. And you want that to still be kind of smooth. Okay, remember this mask has some wrinkles in it as well, so let's make some wrinkles in the mask like that. Okay, now let's go over here. And let's start shaping the top of the head. We don't need this line anymore, so we can erase that. I also erased a little bit over here. Now from here, from the brows, you want to find, all right, so here's the center. Shouldn't have erased that earlier. You want to find an even spacing from there, going up to about there. And then you want this one to go that way, and you want this one to go this way. And then once you're done with that, you can erase this center line like that. All right, it's got some lines over here as well, going this way, and they're very faint. In a line like this. Now let's go back over here and let's start drawing in that flash lightning symbol. And what we want to do is we want to create an oval, and the side of the oval should be touching the edge just like this. And you want to make that a little thicker, so double up on that oval there so that it's got this thickness, and that's a good thickness for it. Okay. Now let's find two points, one here and one here. You want this point to go out like that, and you want this point to be similar in angle to this. So it goes out like this. And once you get to this point, you want to draw a line going across, and over here, a line across like that. All right. From here, you want to draw a little line going out like that, and same thing over here, a tiny little line going out. I'm going to erase some of these lines right here so that you can see a little bit more clearly. But this is where this to there, you want to make them meet. And then from here to there. So there's a faint little space from here to here. Okay, you want this one to go across, that one goes across slightly. From this point, you want to go across again. So you make this point right here, like that. Now, middle point to this point, and then from here to here. And then lastly, here, going across like this. And you want to close that off, and same thing over here, close that off like that. All right, so now let's go over here and let's draw these wrinkles, I guess you could call them, around the earpiece. So one goes like that, and I'm going to draw another one over here like this. There you go. So that's let's draw a line right here. And that kind of that's sort of how you draw it. Now let's zoom out and let's add details to the rest of the body or rest of the shoulders, and we should be good from there. So let's find the seam right here. That's one seam, little wrinkle from here. I'm just going to draw a little wrinkle going this way. Now you want these three lines right here to extend to the center of this circle. So going down like this, and then you want it to go this way, and here, and here. All right, you want to darken the center one a little bit more. And when you ink it, you want this one to be thicker than the other two. Okay, and over here, I do the center line first, and then here's the center, and then the other two lines. Just like that. Same thing here. Just like that. And I want to draw a little wrinkle right there. From here, I'm going to draw a line from there to there. And I want to draw it twice. So I want to double that up like that. Same for the shoulder. And right here, we got some texture. So what you want to do is you want to follow this curve right here. And you just keep going like that. And because it's a rough texture, you kind of want to make this a little zigzaggy. Okay, now the shoulder, we can smooth that one out. Actually, no, it's got that rough texture as well. So right here, see how this is doubled up? You want to bring it up like this because you want to make that lightning insignia. So this goes up and like this. That's a little lightning right there. And you want to do the same thing on this side. Just keep going. And as you move this way, you want to start turning it vertically like this. Not vertically, horizontally, my bad. So you want to make it so that you're slowly turning like that. Let me just fix this up a little bit. All right. You got some zigzaggy lines like this that go from the side to the emblem, and from the emblem to the side like that. You just want to make them very random, not uniform at all. Yeah. Okay. Now let's finish it off on this side. Actually, right here. Right here, you want to bring it out this way towards the seam. And the seam, you want it to go up, and then you want it down. And you want to double that up. All right. Keep going on the seam, going down and up like this. Shoulder. And then the ridges. If you're confident in doing the ridges during the inking part, then you don't have to do it in pencil. Saves you time that way. Okay, roughen that up a little bit. Just like that. Now we go over here. Again, those same wrinkles, lightning bolt shapes, or whatever, what have you. From there, like that. And from here, going towards the insignia. And I think I'll leave it like that. Once you have that, you should be finished. So that is how you draw a black flash from the flash. And that is all the time that we have. Thank you for watching this video to the very end. If you are proud of your drawings, I would love to see it. So please go to the Google Plus community and post your artwork there for all of us to enjoy. If you are curious about the equipment that I use to do my tutorials or to make my videos, I have links to those in the description below. Clicking on those links helps to ensure that content creators like myself are supported so that we can continue making good stuff like this for you guys free of charge. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you guys subscribe. Here in this channel, I show you how to draw your favorite characters in easy to follow, simple step-by-step instructions. So if you guys do like what you see, please hit that subscribe button below this video. And if you guys feel like being awesome and you want to support this channel even more, I have a support button that is on the main page of my channel. I have merchandise for sale, such as this shirt right here and this mug right here. Links to those in the description. Anyway, if you guys did enjoy this tutorial, it would help me a great deal if you guys liked this video, commented below, or shared this video with your friends in social media. And speaking of social media, don't forget you guys can find me on Facebook, Instagram, Google+, and on my website, drawitoo.com, where you can download a coloring page of this tutorial and my other tutorials in this channel. Again, links below. Finally, thank you once again, and as always, stay tuned for more so you can learn to draw too. I'll see you guys in my next video.